Hola. Muchas gracias.
Gracias a ti, mi amor.
¿Cómo se llama?
Lalita.
Lalita, soy Luis. Muchas gracias.
Mucho gusto.
Ya, mucho gusto. Comida es muy bien. Muy sabroso.
Que te vaya muy bien.
Yeah.
Hey, travel friends. I hope all is well with you. My name is LJ, and welcome to the vlog. Today, my travel friends, we arrived in Santiago, Chile. Wow. Santiago is the capital of Chile, and yo, this is so different from Buenos Aires. This is day one, and we are diving right into the food culture. We are going to the main, the famous supermarket here in Santiago. It's they sell fresh seafood. And they cook it for you. So let me read the exact name of the place. It's called Mercado Central de Santiago. So that's where we're going. It's about an 8-minute walk from my apartment. So I rented this cool Airbnb. One thing though, it's hot right now in Santiago and there's no AC in my Airbnb. So that was a little bit tough, but as the night got deeper, it got cooler. It's about 64 degrees last night after like 12 midnight. So I cracked open the window and yeah, we're all good. Anyway, head on to our destination. Almost there. This is one of the churches here in Santiago. By the way, I live in the downtown central of Santiago, Chile. So most of the old historical and tourist attraction is circulated around the area. Look at those mountains over there, man. This is beautiful. Today's actually not that hot. I mean, I thought it was gonna be really hot, but it's doable. So I'm walking on the street of Plaza de Mayo, just like what they have in Buenos Aires. Downtown center, there always gonna be a Plaza de Mayo. And interesting fact here, if you see that guy with the purple claw, this street on this little seats, what do you call it? Yeah, there's a lot of tarot card readers that will read your fortune for free, of course. And I just saw it yesterday. I was walking around the area and I saw it being done, which is super cool. I kind of want to do it, but my Spanish is very limited, so I don't know how it's gonna work for me. But we might try it. So the streets are empty, closed stores everywhere, only because it's a Sunday and people respect their holidays, their religious holidays actually here. Being a very Catholic country in that. Even though Saturdays as well, they're also closed. I grew up in a very Catholic country, also the Philippines, and Sundays we are also closed, but not Saturdays. I don't know. Anyway, onwards. I think we have arrived at the market. It's the main market, I think. Let's go walk and find out a little bit more of the market and see what's inside. Oh, thank God for the breeze. So it is just a little warning. There's gonna be like dead animals. It's a fresh market, so they have fishes inside and a lot of seafood. And yeah, this is it. This is the famous market. And I already know where to go. I researched a little bit on where to go. I think the place that I'm gonna go first is El Rey. Where is El Rey? Yep, fresh fish everywhere. Oh, restaurants. Look at the fish. So cool. Yo, there's fishes everywhere. I've been to wet markets all over Asia. And this is quite interesting. Like a mercado. Squid. Interesting. So we are at the heart of the market where most of the restaurants are located. I'm lucky that they're open on a Sunday right now, but let's take a stroll. The restaurant I'm looking for is called El Rey Marisco. I've heard and I've read really good reviews about it. So let's walk around the area. I'll show you. This is Center Fountain. Let's go here first. La Jolla Pacific. No, not that one. Not Agosto. I don't know where is it. So let's see. I was here yesterday. I didn't eat. I just had a beer and was watching the game. There's a big screen over there. Yeah, I come back.
Maybe later.
Yeah, later. Let me tour around first.
Okay.
Thank you. Yeah, so there's a big screen over there. They're very nice. They're selling products. Products is food. Yeah, that's a big screen. Netherlands. Oh, Argentina is too. Yo. Of course, I expected Argentina to win. But where is the restaurant? Is that it? Okay, let's find it. We will find. If not, Google will help. Alright, I think I know where the restaurant is, but we have to go pass through this fish market again. Wet market. No, gracias. We have to go outside. Let's see, we're selling. Yep. We're just exiting because the restaurant is outside. This is. Okay. Just exited the center market. I'm looking for El Rey. Can't find it. Let's go. Look. That's the port over there. Is that the port? Ooh, I see a church that looks like one of those Baroque churches in Barcelona. But I'm not sure where El Rey is though. El Rey. Yo, I can't find it. Let's go back. So this is the fruit market anyway. It's just outside the main wet fish seafood market. So this is the fruit market. One thing you notice also here is the people are more diverse than Buenos Aires. It's not just like white folks walking everywhere. It's such a mixture. So strawberries. Strawberries is 1,000. 1,000 for a cherry. 1,000 is like $1.30. Oh, El Rey. Is this El Rey? Oh, no. Stick with school. I'm really hungry and I can't find El Rey. So we might just go to the next nice seafood restaurant that we can find. But you know, the reviews were good for El Rey. I'm really hoping I can find it. Oh, Rincon is here. All right, let's start. Sorry. I still don't know where I'm eating. The prices look good here. $9 for a ceviche. 10. Should we eat in this really local place? Maybe. You know what? I feel like I should eat here. And this is very nice. Very local. I don't know. I'm really scared. I don't know, anxious to eat, and I don't have cash right now. So I'm looking for a place where I can. Sorry, my eyes hurt from the SPF that I placed. So I'm looking for a place where I can pay with a credit card, because I don't have cash. Most of the exchange places here are closed on Saturdays and Sundays, so just FYI. And we have decided to eat in this really local place. It's called Lolita. So skipping the big fancy restaurants and enjoying this local. Get back in there for food and I'll come back to you later. So I just ordered. Oh, it's in the dark, so yeah, let me do it by the way. Here. You see me now? So, and this song. I don't know how much I'm gonna pay, but I ordered. I had the pressure from ordering from the waiter. I've traveled so far, but I still get this anxiety from ordering when you don't know the language. So, with my poor Spanish, I should have recorded it. Yeah, it's pretty loud right now. I'm not sure if you can hear me. And the music. Anyway, I ordered a ceviche. It's called ceviche renita. I ordered ceviche renita. I ordered this one, the fish. Fried fish, craving for fried fish, or fried fish and chips actually. And I had a local beer, so let's see how that goes. So you get two slices of lemon, I guess, for the fish, for the people, and that bread. And that bread. Yes, yeah. Ooh, and we got this escudo. So it's supposed to be a Chilean beer, and yeah. So the ceviche is here, my friends. Oh, that looks so good. So, FYI, I don't really eat, I don't really enjoy raw food, but when I went to Peru and had a ceviche there, also Filipinas, we have a ceviche, it's called kinilaw, but it's mostly well cooked in vinegar, and just like that, it looks like it's well cooked to vinegar. So this might be a good thing. Let's try it. Okay, I'm gonna put you here because the lighting is just bad on that side. All right, do you see it? Yeah, you can see it. Yo. Ceviche. Oh, this reminds me of my dad so much. Dad, I know you're in heaven, but yeah, I'm eating this for you too. Oh, it's so good. Try some bread. A different angle again, but yo, time to drink a beer. This is turning out to be like a food vlog. Or I'm sorry for my beer drinking friends. I don't know how to pour beer actually. Still good. Eating in a local market in Santiago, Chile. Thumbs up. Got it.
I'm gonna show you.
It's a big portion.
Very good. Yeah.
Very happy Asian because it has rice in it. And the fish that you saw on my plate here right now, it came from the market over there. Fresh. So I'll put in the price after I eat, but it already looks good, and I'm happy I sat here instead of the other restaurant because that looks like a bit more expensive place to go. It's very local. It's right by the door. Yeah, sorry, I burped. Let's eat. That's all the food I can take in for today. I finished most of my fried fish and maybe half of the ceviche because it was just a lot of food. And while we're at this restaurant, while I was eating, the nice owner or cook of the place, I think she's the owner too. Oh, my macaroni is so bad. Anyway, yeah, she surprised me with that gift. They gave me a magnetic reminder of Chile, and it's so cool. It's like a postcard, but it's a magnetic metal. And she's about to go and pay, and I'll take a video of her and thank her for that. And I'll show you which restaurant I ate today. Okay, I'm gonna go just say hi and thank her for this. Hola. Hola. Muchas gracias.
Gracias a ti, mi amor.
¿Cómo se llama?
Lalita.
Lalita, soy Luis. Muchas gracias.
Mucho gusto.
Ya, mucho gusto. Comida es muy ya. Bien. Muy sabroso.
Que te vaya muy bien.
Ya. Es San Antonio, Lalita. That is the place where I get my food. And yeah, I'm about to pay right now. Thank you so much.
Muchas gracias.
So in Chile, I'm happy to be an American Express credit card owner because they accept American Express here in Chile. Like, yeah. I'm surprised. Even in small markets like this, take American Express. So to my American Express lovers there, you'll be at home in Chile. Even the small markets like this accept American Express. The total amount of my food is 18,000. So that's about $19 to $20 U.S. dollars for a ceviche, two big fillet fish, rice, and beer. So yeah, it's not as cheap as Buenos Aires, but it's doable. Although it's not gonna be sustainable if I spend this much money for a meal here in Chile. I left the restaurant that I had my food at, and I stopped recording because they started to drill and it was kind of too loud for you guys and for me, especially for you guys. But yeah, it was really good food, people were nice there, and I have a gift. So yeah, I'm satisfied with today's lunch. The experience for first day is amazing so far. So let's do a little walk around.
I've decided to go around the market to that fruit stand where we were, because I feel like there's more happening in that area. Oh my god, I really like it now. I like the grittiness of where I am. It's so opposite from the posh neighborhood I lived in Buenos Aires, in Palermo in general. I have barbecue. Oh, that looks so good. It's barbecue. I want to eat, but I don't have cash. It needs cash. Okay, let me turn the camera around so you can see where I'm going.
So,
No. So the police is here, just like most smaller countries. They take our, I don't know, they take stuff from the street vendors, like they, because it's illegal for rental to sell stuff on the street, just like in the Philippines also, street vendors are discouraged to do that. I feel bad. That's how it is. Anyway, this is us walking back to the apartment. Oh yeah, street vendors, I feel bad for them. Now the street is a little bit cleared because the police came here. So far, I feel safe, which might be weird to a lot of people, because crowded spaces like this. But you gotta watch out. I mean, I'm not just filming myself and not looking around, watching for like petty crimes, like pickpocketing or like stuff. Like my hand is on my pocket because my cell phone is there. Also, my wallet is in here. Just gonna take extra precautions when you're around these crowded spaces, not just here in Chile, but all over the world in general. Just gotta be aware, and then you will eventually meet hecklers, or is it hecklers? People that literally push things for you to buy. Yeah. So diving deeper into this street of stuff of. Yo, that's local hospitality. Okay, I'm trying to find out what street is this, because it's a cool street. I'm not sure if it only happens on the weekend, because yesterday it was like this. Today it's even more. It's called Paseo Puente. Stay open. That's it. Sorry. Stay open. All right. I found a supermercado. A supermarket. I'm not sure if I'm allowed to take a video inside, but I'm here. So, yeah. I'll see you later. Let me buy something first. Well, I think I'm allowed to film inside. Unless they're gonna kick me out, I'm gonna get out. But yeah, let me just. Okay. Found that. Washing for my. Okay. It's annoying. You know what? Let me just. Catch you later. It's weird bringing you here to the supermarket. We're not doing a supermarket tour anyway. But anyway, this is their supermarket here. Just like any supermarkets in the world. Catch you later.
Okay, and we are home. We did find groceries. Oof, so hot. So, let's see what we got. I have ice cream, and it's pineapple flavored ice cream. Sabor piña. And I was gonna get like dulce de leche because I'm so used to Argentina, but this is very common flavor. This is a very common flavor that they have at the grocery. So, you know, I got to get one of that. And pricing, okay, this is a quick pricing. That is 2,400, so $2, $2.50, $2.75. I got some, I thought it was paper towel, but it's toilet paper. So this is 1,279, so $1.30. Coffee is $2.99, $3. Instant coffee, this, yeah. We have some peanuts for mani limon, $1.80, $2. And a 2,250 ml water, 2 point something liters, $1.50. And laundry soap, because I have to wash my undergarments and I wash it my hands because it's weird to drop it off at the washer and have someone mess with your undergarments. So
yeah,
so I wash it by hand. It is a 60-cent soap and a bag, because they don't have free bags here. You have to bring your own bag because they don't do disposable bags, which is really good. But this bag is about 50 cents. And the total for all of that is 10,615. So that's about $10-$11. Not bad.
Anyway, so I'm gonna end this vlog of day one supermarket eating local food vlog for today. That's for day one. Catch you later, travel friends. Take care. And if you do like this content and if you enjoy the vlog, don't forget to please like, comment, ask your questions there, and subscribe. We're still going for 1,000 followers at the end of the year. If not at the end of the year, hopefully for the first quarter of next year, because we kind of started late for this year. But please comment, like, and subscribe. See you later, travel friends. Ciao.